Today we're going to look at a generalization of the graph Cartesian product to hypergraphs. To review, the Cartesian product of graphs G and H returns a graph with a vertex set equal to the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of G and H, and in which a pair of vertices are adjacent if their left coordinates are the same vertex and their right coordinates are adjacent, or if their left coordinates are adjacent and their right coordinates are the same vertex. Intuitively, the Cartesian product ends up copying one factor graph for every vertex in the other factor graph, and then linking the vertices of each copy according to the structure of the other factor graph. So how can we generalize this to hypergraphs? Let's start by narrowing down the kinds of hypergraphs we're going to consider in this video. Unless otherwise stated, we're going to be considering hypergraphs without repeated or empty edges. The Cartesian product of hypergraphs G and H is a hypergraph with vertex set equal to the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of G and H, and with edge set equal to the union of the set of all ordered pairs whose left coordinates are the same and whose right coordinates form an edge in H, with the set of all ordered pairs whose right coordinates are the same and whose left coordinates form an edge in G. Do you see how this generalizes the Cartesian product of graphs? If we consider graphs to be two uniform hypergraphs, then the hypergraph Cartesian product of two graphs has the same vertex set as the graph Cartesian product of those graphs. And since all edges have size 2, any set of vertices that forms an edge is actually an adjacent pair of vertices, meaning that our edge rule is equivalent to that for the graph Cartesian product. So far, the hypergraph Cartesian product satisfies a couple of nice properties. The vertex set is the Cartesian product of the factor hypergraph vertex sets, and the hypergraph Cartesian product of two graphs is the same as the graph Cartesian product of those two graphs. Also, the edges of the product depend on the edges of both factors. Let's work through an example now. What's the Cartesian product of these two hypergraphs? First, find the vertex set. Here it is. Next, let's look for all edges of the first form, which is where the left coordinates are the same and the right coordinates form an edge. Starting with left coordinate A, what sets of vertices form an edge in the right factor hypergraph, H? There's only one set of these that forms an edge. 1, 2, 3. So, in the product, the vertices A1, A2, and A3 form an edge. Next, for left coordinates B, C, and D, we'll have the same situation. The only edge that we can form using the possible right coordinates of 1, 2, and 3 is 1, 2, 3, so we get the following edges in our product. Notice that these edges form the copies of our second factor hypergraph in the product. Next, let's find the edges of the second type, those that are inherited from the left factor. Let's fix our right coordinate to be 1. What edges are present in the left factor? There's only one, A, B, C, D. So A1, B1, C1, D1 is an edge in our product. And as we fix our right coordinates to be 2 and then 3, we can also produce only one edge, giving us the following edges in our product. Like the graph Cartesian product, we can choose to view the hypergraph Cartesian product as an operation that replaces each vertex in one of the factors with a copy of the other factor. And then we produce edges between vertices in different copies according to the edges present in the other factor. Let's do another example. First, find the vertex set. Next, let's find all the edges whose left coordinates are the same and whose right coordinates form an edge in the right factor. In this case, there's two edges in the right factor, 2, 4, 5, and 1, 2, 3. So for each fixed left coordinate, we'll be generating two edges in the product. Fixing our left coordinate as A We can generate the edges A2, A4, A5, and A1, A2, A3. Fixing our left coordinate as B, we can generate the edges B2, B4, B5, and B1, B2, B3. Now let's find all the edges of the second kind, whose right coordinates are the same and whose left coordinates form an edge. In this case, there's just one edge in the left factor graph. So we're looking for sets of edges whose right coordinates are the same and whose left coordinates are A and B. Fixing the right coordinate to be 1, we get the edge A1, B1, and fixing the right coordinate to be 2, we get the edge A2, B2. Can you finish the product from here? Continuing in this way, we get 3 more edges. This is the finished product of our hypergraphs. Now watch what happens if we take the 2 section of this product, and then compare this 2 section to the 2 sections of the factor hypergraphs. Do you notice anything interesting? The 2 section of the product is the graph Cartesian product of the 2 sections of the factor hypergraphs. This will be true in general. This is because vertices are adjacent in the 2 section when they share an edge in the hypergraph. And in the hypergraph product, vertices share an edge precisely when their right coordinates share an edge and their left coordinates are the same, or their left coordinates share an edge and their right coordinates are the same. If we use that as our adjacency condition for the 2 section of a product, we can observe that it's essentially the same as the adjacency condition for the Cartesian product of the 2 sections of the factor hypergraphs. Moving on, let's take a look at some more properties. If we have a hypergraph H that's the product of hypergraphs H1 and H2, then the number of edges, or the size of H, is the number of vertices of H1 times the number of edges of H2, plus the number of vertices of H2 times the number of edges of H1. We can look to one of our previous hypergraphs to demonstrate this. Note that this formula for the number of edges in a hypergraph Cartesian product is the same formula as that for the number of edges of a graph Cartesian product. Also, like the graph Cartesian product, the degree of a vertex x, y, and h will be the sum of the degree of x in H1 with the degree of y in H2. The size of the largest edge in H will be the maximum of the size of the largest edge of H1 and of H2. A vertex in the product is isolated if and only if both its coordinates are isolated in their factor hypergraphs. To finish the video, let's look at just 2 more properties of the hypergraph Cartesian product. To review, the Helly property is when every set of mutually adjacent edges in a hypergraph have at least a single vertex in common. A set of edges that are pairwise adjacent is known as an intersecting family, while a set of edges with a non-empty intersection is known as a star. So the Helly property means all intersecting families are stars. Now it turns out that the Cartesian product of 2 Helly hypergraphs is also Helly. To see why, observe that there are 2 types of edges in a Cartesian product. Let's call the edges with fixed left coordinate type 1 and edges with fixed right coordinate type 2. Using this terminology, there are essentially 3 types of intersecting families in a Cartesian product. Those that are made up entirely of type 1 edges, made up entirely of type 2 edges, and those containing a mixture of type 1 and type 2 edges. If both factor graphs are Helly, type 1 edges alone and type 2 edges alone can never form an intersecting family that's not a star, as otherwise one of the factors would not be Helly. So every intersecting family involving only type 1 or only type 2 edges must be a star. How about the intersecting families that involve a mixture of edge types? There's a useful fact about these. Every type 1 edge in such a family must have the same fixed left coordinate. That is, we can't have edges like this in any intersecting family in the hypergraph product because type 1 edges with different left coordinates can't intersect anywhere. Similarly, Every intersecting family involving only type 2 edges must have the same fixed right coordinate. We can partition any intersecting family F of mixed edge types into an intersecting family S of edge type 1 and T of edge type 2. We know that every edge in S must intersect every edge in T because F is an intersecting family. From our earlier results, we know that all edges in S have the same left coordinate and all edges in T have the same right coordinate. Let's call these coordinates A and B. We can now say that there's only one vertex that any edge in S can intersect any edge in T by. It must be the vertex AB. This means that every edge in S intersects every edge in T at the vertex AB in our product, meaning there's a single vertex AB that's present in all edges in our intersecting family F, meaning it's a star. Because F was an arbitrary intersecting family, we can now say that every intersecting family in this hypergraph product is a star. Or in other words, the hypergraph product is Helly. Notice that our theorem fails if either of the factors are not Helly, as that would mean that there's an intersecting family that's not a star in one of the copies of the non-Helly factor, rendering the product non-Helly as well. This lets us strengthen our theorem into a biconditional statement. Moving on to our final property, it's also true that the product of two conformal hypergraphs is a conformal hypergraph. To see why, we can turn to the fact that the two section of the Cartesian product of two hypergraphs is the graph Cartesian product of the factor hypergraph's two sections. Remember that conformal means that the set of maximal clicks of the two section is the same as the set of maximal edges of the hypergraph. The maximal clicks of a graph Cartesian product are going to be made up entirely of vertices with the same left coordinate and right coordinates forming a maximal click, or entirely made up of vertices with the same right coordinate and left coordinates forming a maximal click. Intuitively, this means that in the two section of the hypergraph Cartesian product, maximal clicks will be entirely within one copy of a factor. Recall that if a maximal click of a two section is an edge in the hypergraph, it must be a maximal edge. This means that if there were any maximal click in the two section of the product that was not a maximal edge in the product, it would be implied that there's a maximal click in the two section of one of the factor hypergraphs that was not a maximal edge in that factor hypergraph, contradicting that all our factors are conformal. So the product hypergraph has to be conformal. Similarly, we also arrive at a contradiction if there was a maximal edge in the product that was not a maximal click in the two section, proving that our product is conformal. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and click the like button. Have a great day.